Hello friends, Iclone Toad Animation here. This is the final part of Law and Order. I want to quickly apologize for uploading this late. It's due to the nature of my work. However, I have some time in my hands today, so I'll be showing you what you have on ground. I have so many things to upload later during the week, and people made requests. I've been able to get everything that you guys asked for. I'll be uploading them as the time goes on, as I have time. And I also have some good tutorials now on how to use Iclone for quick scene arrangement, where you can, Iclone is not a modeling software, but we can also use some of the 3D props that they have here to make some quick scene, good quick scene arrangements that we need. Some props and some buildings. So I have made some tutorials, and I'll be uploading them very soon. So just relax and let's jump into it. Before we start, if you've not subscribed to my channel, I think it's the right time you subscribe to my channel and press the notification button so you can be notified if anytime I upload any tutorial or any free models. I have so many free models because I've upgraded to Iclone 7.6, and with this one I can easily export OBG and FBX directly into the Iclone viewport or into the Iclone interface, so not going through a 3D exchange anymore. That has helped me a lot to make all my FBX and my OBGs into iProps. So I have so many things that I love to share, and I hope I have the time to share them. If you have anything you need at all, just drop it in comment below and I will see how fast I can reach you. You can also drop it and drop your email address. That'll be easier for me. I might not be able to upload it directly because of time. Okay, so let's jump into it. Law and Order Part 3. What do we have? Now here we have the first one to look at is a weapon. This weapon, I morphed it. I took some time out to morph it to make some things work. We have the laser. We have you're going to enjoy this weapon. So let's go into animation. We're going to the morph animator. Just click your morph animator. You see all these sliders here. It shows that it has been morphed. I may not be able to show because of time, but let me just show you a little bit of what I've done here. Now this slider is for the accessory, the top accessory here, for the movement of the top accessory. Unfortunately, when I was morphing it, I forgot to unlink this, so most of the morph move with this, but that does not withstand. You can use it very well. And we have this for the back slider here. When you just use it, you are going to enjoy using it. You can animate the morph. If we go down now to, let me just quickly show you how to animate the morph. If we go down, you click on the assault rifle, click on this, and you see the morph here. This is the morph here. I hope you're seeing it. Just go down on morph. You're going to see everything that has been morphed. So all you need to do is, the normal way you animate, you push, make your move your morph sliders. What you want to morph, you morph it. It's just the same way you do your normal animations. I should let you know that you can animate with the morph sliders. Okay, so I don't think we should waste too much time here, but just know that almost everything in this assault rifle has been morphed. Almost everything has been morphed, including the trigger. a fire. I put a fire here. I know you might not use it, but you know you can change the color if you want to change the color. Though, I just put there for those people that might not be able to have fire to use. It has been morphed, you see? And you can, like I said before, you can animate it and it's just going to move well, and you can okay. So I think I'll just end here. Just when you have this, just go through, just go to your morph animator and test everything you have here. It's quite much. Okay, that's for the assault rifle. Now we're going to check out the police conference room. The last time I uploaded a conference room, but they were just, it's not a complete scene. This one is different. So now this is the police conference room. You have everything here is movable, like, you know, with all my props, they're all movable. You can use them for other things. You can change the way they look, you can change the arrangements, and you can even change the pictures, or you can even put videos like this. Let me see if I can quickly put a video I just made. Okay, see, you can just place your video, and depends on what you want to do. You can put your video, you can put your pictures, you can put practically anything. For those that don't know how to use this, simple. Double click on the screen and put a video if you want to put a video. Just did this guy smoking cigarettes. Okay, that's for that. Everything here, like I said, is movable. You can change the flag. If you don't like the flag, you want to put your country flag, all you have to do is to go straight to your to Google, look for your country flag. If you cannot make one in Photoshop or the editing software you're using, just go straight to Google, check your country flag or the country you want to use, double click on the flag, look here for flag, where is this, and just double click on it, and then you open the let me use a picture here, double click on it and just open, let's say this is the flag, click on it. I like to unmake the texture. Now the flag will show, like this picture is showing here, it has changed to this picture. Your flag will appear here. Just have to use it. Everything here, the projector can be moved. Let's not waste too much time here. We're going to go into the next one, which is the next one. Let's look at the evidence room, where police keep the evidence. Don't forget, this is law and order. So it has to do with, everything has to do with the law and what goes with the law. And this is the evidence room. Let's align it so we can open the door. Where police keep the evidence. Okay, you have the cartons. Like, you know, with my props, you can move them, carry them, drop them. Everything here is movable. So that's the evidence room. Let's go into the next one, would be I did another interrogation scene, because I had to bring in a lie detector, something a little bit different from what I did before. So this is a lie detector that you can use with your coffee, your pen on the table. You can see the pen is also movable and you can use it. Okay, and this is a lie detector, just something that will be on ground for you to use when you're interrogating the suspect. We have the cameras around, we have the the evidence glass where, you know, you don't see. Okay, so this is a nice one that you can use for your scene. And the next we're going to go into now, you're going to like it because this is, it's massive. I'm going to check out pardon me, suspect. Okay, let's check this one first. I did a new locker room, a more modern locker room, the police locker room. Okay, there's a locker room, and everything here is also movable. And use it for your sins. Police locker room. This locker room can also be used from if you're doing schools, you know, high school. You can use it for your locker room too. But this is a police locker room. Okay. Now we're going to the suspect and the witness room. This is massive. This is massive. I need to move out here. This is a complete. The suspect room and the witness room. Okay, let's go in and see how it looks like inside. Okay, it's easier for me to get in. Yeah. Yeah, this is the and this is the weakness room, I should think. Sorry, still trying to get a hold. It's better just make this top invisible. Oh no, no. Anyway, this is the weakness room. When you get it, you check it out. You have where the weakness will stay and the suspects will line up to see where the weakness will identify the suspect to see if they committed the offense or not. However, I'm not able to get into the room now. I have to try and get there. This might just create some unnecessary delay, which I do not want. I don't want this to be too long. Okay, this is just the that is so confusing for even for me. The lineup, yeah, good. This is where the weakness, the suspects line up. We just seen the police scene where the line, when they line them up, you use this for your measurements, the height, and this can be moved too, like, you know, with all my props. Okay, and the other room up of this is the number they hold, you know, they normally hold the number where they put on their chest to know if they are the one. Yeah. Why the weakness will stay here to identify so that the suspect will not know who is identifying who, which. So it's quite massive. Just check the rooms out and you understand what I'm saying. Okay. Now let's go to what we have next. I said to add vehicles, and the vehicles have been morphed also. Police vehicles, just to make it complete. I already uploaded this before, but not morphed. This one is morphed. However, there's a catch. The catch is you'll not be able to select those things you need, especially the tires. So in the one I uploaded both the morphed and the ones that are not morphed. So in case you want to combine them, you can, because the other one is the OBJ form, where you can select everything individually. But the morphed one, you can't select it because it is morphed. So you have some certain things that are already done, like the tires rolling. Unfortunately, when the tire roll, if anybody has an idea how to do this, please let me know. I've been trying it. When you can make the tires roll with this, you can open the door. All the doors can be opened. Excuse me. And that's this way I have a problem. The tire begin to increase. That's why I think you cannot use this tire. This one. Just delete it. So that's one of the reasons I added. That's one of the reasons I added the OBJ version of this police car, just in case you want to combine them. That's the Metro, and this is the SWAT. This is the SWAT vehicle. I also added the OBJ version of the SWAT vehicle. I love this SWAT car. It's complete. Everything inside is complete. Let's check out the morph animator. Just go to your morph animator and we need to use it. This is for the computer inside to make it rotate. I think this is for the hatch up, to open the hatch, to rotate the hatch. Yeah, to open the hatch, you have about three hatches up. This is to make your animation a little bit easier. It's easier to animate with the morph sliders than to animate directly on the timeline. That's what I have noticed, so I prefer to do this for the doors open and close. All the doors open and close. Okay. I tried to work on the wheels. Unfortunately, I was successful to work on the wheels to bend left and right, I think. However, I can't make it rotate, so that's why I have to put the extra, so you can select the wheel and make it rotate. And the inside is complete. This is a complete vehicle. You can use the inside and outside. Don't forget, this is law and order. This is a computer. You can put anything in front of the computer. You can rotate the computer. Okay, that's all for the props. However, that's not the end. I decided to add some characters this time, so that you to be a complete package for you. So let's go into a character. Let's go into custom characters. Let's look for law and order. Yeah, I placed three major characters here. We have they all have their weapons. Something you can use. They're all CC3. You can use them with your CC3. Can be edited in CC3. Okay. The hat. You can change it to accessory. I didn't have time to do that, but just know that they are complete characters with the walkie-talkie. The walkie-talkie, I think, is an accessory here. I think, yeah, I did that as an accessory. So you can use them the way you want to use them. There's one character. Let's bring another character. So guys, if you've not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel. And there's some good stuff. If you need anything in 3D, just let me know. Any software you need, let me know. I'll try and get them for you. Okay, it's free. I'm not charging anything for this. I'm working on my Patreon account, and I hope you guys will support me. Yeah, this one is also complete character. The weapons, they are all, the weapons are accessories which you can use. Everything, the stick, everything, he is complete. And also we have another one here. So guys, please subscribe to my channel. Come with some good tutorials, and I hope you will enjoy it. Like I said, I do not know it all. You know, I'm just new to Iclone. I'm barely a year old using Iclone, so it's something I love to do. This for me is hobby, it's not my job, but I love it, and I want to share with people what I know, and I think I can learn from people too. So the more I make tutorials, people make some corrections, and I will learn from them. Yeah, so this is the last policeman. And also somebody asked for somebody said they needed some a meta human, so I had to create one from my Android that I posted before. I hope this will do. He said either male or female, does not matter. So I created this, but everybody can go for this. She is complete metal. Complete metal. The person needed height, but I just did normal height, but actually you can all you need to do is to come to the scale and increase the scale. So let's just take this to 2. Okay, and press enter, and there you get the height. It's complete. Okay, so for those, if you need a giant, a metal giant, she can walk, she can talk. It depends on what you want to do. It depends on how slow you want it to talk. You can do everything here in Iclone. I love Iclone, okay? I don't think we should put intermissions anyway. Everything here is good. So guys, that's the end of my upload for today, for this week. I hope I won't take up to 2 weeks before I do my next upload. In my tutorials, I will also be uploading some free stuff, because since we use for the tutorials, we'll be uploaded too. So just be expecting some good stuff. Like I said, in the tutorials is how I know it. I'm going to do it. I know there are better ways of doing it, but I'll do it how I know it. If you know a better way, please you drop in the description when the tutorial comes out. Like I said, if you have anything you need in 3D software, assets, props, FBX, OBJ, Maya, C4D, and so on, plugins, just let me know in the comments below, and I'll see how far I can assist you. And if you just put it, just put your email address there, so it will be easy for me to contact you. Thank you very much guys for watching, and I hope to see you some other time. Bye.